I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Today I get to fix the roof. They have two wind turbines up there that are making a bunch of racket. I think they just need to be maybe lubricated. They do require some maintenance, but they rattle around and they're making some crazy noises, and that crazy noise when it rattles in the wind gets basically transmitted throughout the house and creates a little bit of vibration and makes it a whole lot louder than it appears to be. For a while there I thought it was my neighbor's roof, but then I realized he doesn't have wind turbines, so it's got to be me. So since I've never done this before, I'm gonna basically pack up a whole bunch of crap and take it up on the roof and see if it's something I can take care of. They cost about $35-40 a piece, so, but I think it just needs some maintenance because I don't think it's ever been done, and evidently according to the internets, you gotta do some maintenance every once in a while. So loads of fun. All right, everybody, so I've gathered most of my tools and stuff that I think I might need on the roof because I really don't know, so I kind of went for overkill. I got, you know, things like a box cutter, I got Phillips and flathead screwdrivers, relatively long, so if I can pry. A couple sets of vice grips that were already in here, including a ever popular, or one of my favorites, the needle nose style vice grips. Cobalt. Little socket and wrench, or excuse me, socket set, ratchet. Just in case, they're not real big. I don't think I'm gonna need that many. Got my gloves. Ratcheting screwdriver. Got the drill. 2 hours ought to be enough. Wire ties underneath. In case I can't get them fixed, I can always zip them so they stop making all that damn noise. It's probably bad if it rains, but you know. Got a multi-tool. Never know when you might need a multi-tool. Just in case. Got the tape measure. Instead of using regular WD-40, I'm going to use motor oil in this oil can right here. And if that doesn't work, I've got some good old PB blaster. So I think I've just about got it covered with a drill and everything else. You know, I can't see what else I'd need. I might need an adjustable wrench. I'll use a small adjustable wrench. I think that'll just about do it because I've got some other channel locks and things down at the bottom, the longer screwdrivers and a hammer, good old S-tuning hammer. So I think that'll do it. We'll see. I think I'm gonna throw in some wrenches for good measure. So my goal is to go up on the roof and get this done, or at least figure out what the issue is, without actually having to come back down off the roof to get something that I forgot. Because it's always a pain. I can't think of anything else I'd need. Let me see. Yeah. We'll go with this and see what happens. I'm gonna put the even little shoulder pad on there so I can shoulder strap so I can get up there. Okay, well, I've made it up on the roof. It's pretty scary for me. But there's the turbo. Can you hear it? Or the turbine, I should say. What's funny is with the CMOS sensor in this camera, it's spinning so fast it looks like it's not spinning at all. I did it from an angle, you can kind of get almost an idea how fast it's going. Because the turbine's spinning so quick, it's having the opposite effect on rolling shutter. There. That stopped. But this is loud. Like a, I'm thinking I just need a little maintenance. I don't know. We'll have to see. I have no idea how these things work. That one's a little wobbly, making some noise. And I gotta be careful up here. Ridge cap. There's the ladder. And let's see. Roof's gonna need to be replaced sooner or later. It's a lot cleaner than the last time I was up here. Let me see if I can go over to the other one. Whoa. killed myself just then. There's the other guy. Where's Ben? Hey, buddy. What you doing, dude? Yeah, getting down's gonna suck. I hate being up here, because my leg hurts. But yeah, I'm thinking I just need some maintenance. That's what I'm hoping, so. I don't know. We'll see. Let's explore and find out what's going on. Well, here's what I figured out so far. This thing is attached by four screws. And I think I can take it off and see if I can tighten it up or do some maintenance on it. So I think if I take out these three or four screws, I can pull the whole thing off and flip it upside down and see if I need to tighten it up or do some maintenance. So it's kind of neat, these things. These things actually spin all the time. As long as you have the angle right and make sure it's level, you know, slightest amount of breeze, man, and it'll actually start to spin, and hopefully if it spins fast enough, it'll actually go through and pull or evacuate some of the hot or cold air in your attic out, hopefully. I think it works pretty good, so I'm gonna see if I can take this thing off and see what happens. Okay, so I pulled it off. It was only three screws. And there's the inside. Got a little bolt right there. And evidently there's some bearings that are located inside here, and the whole thing's got, actually it's got quite a bit of play in it. That's probably why it sounds so loud. I don't even see that. You know? Let's see over here. So I'm hoping I can just kind of tighten it up, but I have the fear that the bearings are shot. But what I'm gonna try to do is lubricate right in there, where the bearing runs through, down here at the very bottom, where it's kind of sealed as well, and also right in the middle there. I think if I lubricate all those and get it snugged up a little bit, I think it'll be okay. I don't know, never done this before. At least that's my plan. It'd be real easy to tell, these things spin so easy. So I'll take a wrench to it, put some motor oil on it, see what happens. Okay, here's what I kind of figured out. I don't know if you can see this or not. Okay, this is the top of the turbine. And there's a little, that little nut right here. Rides along the shaft. The shaft rides all the way through the turbine, goes down the very bottom where it locks it in. What I did was I actually pulled the top acorn nut off. And then I actually pulled, there's a little cup spacer. I pulled a cup spacer out. And then I actually took a wrench and just kind of snugged this up a little bit, and I think I may have reduced all the play in this thing to where it's not going to go up and down and kind of rattle, you know, like that. So what I'm thinking is that that may have taken care of it. If that be the case, this is going to be cool. One thing I am going to do though is turn around and underneath it go through and lubricate everything, and then hopefully when I put it all back together it won't rattle and be nice and quiet. Because if all it takes is pulling this bolt off, the acorn nut off, and then taking a wrench and just gently snugging it up till the whole thing doesn't have as much up and down play, instead of having to spend $50 for new ones. I think the cheapest I found them was 36 or 24 for just the top piece. So that'd be pretty cool. So we're gonna kind of see how that goes here. But yep, hopefully so far so. Okay, I think that's gonna work. I think I just need to lubricate it at this point. So here's how it went. Acorn nut came off, went in my pocket so I don't lose it. Then you gently lift this up, move it to the side as best you can. See that cup spacer? Cup spacer, there we go, comes off. You snug this bolt down just a little bit to reduce the play in the shaft that runs all the way through to the base of the turbine, which will hold it steady. And then at this point, I'm going to lubricate this top bearing here and all the bearings underneath. So, because the noise I hear now, I think it's just due to the fact that it's just, the, see this bearing, the grease down there on that shaft right in here? It's, yeah, it's all gummy looking and kind of muddy looking. It shouldn't look like that. I think these things actually use like axle grease or something to kind of get them. But I'm gonna lubricate all this point, the point that you see underneath it, and then the one down at the very end with motor oil and let it sit for a minute. I think that's gonna take care of it. And then I'll put the locking washer back on and then the actual bolt snug it back up, and I'll go ahead and reattach it with the screw holes. Now, one thing I did do, I don't know if you can see that right there, is I actually marked with an X from the base of the turbine to the top of the turbine where I took it off, so I know which hole goes where, so that it should be level when I put it back on. Because if it's not level, it's going to be off and it's going to cause vibration, and that's going to create the crap you hear in the house, which is, you know, sound like somebody using an air compressor in your attic. But so far so good. So let me go ahead and lubricate those. Like I said, I could use like PB Blaster or something like that, but I'm thinking motor oil has a tendency to stick around longer, so that's kind of what I'm going to use. So we'll get to that real quick. New oil. I squirted it on there. Got it on all shafts. Been letting it sit for a second. I'm gonna put it back together and see what happens. Okay, wind's picking up. I just put it back on the top just to kind of set it down. Seems to be pretty quiet. So I'm thinking snugging it up a little bit, lubricating the shaft. In other words, doing just basically doing a little bit of maintenance. Seems to be working pretty good. So I think I'm gonna put it all back together and tighten it all down and do the next one. Good thing I only got two. It's kind of nice up here. Kind of pleased at how well this is turning out so far. But yeah, there he is spinning. Very quiet. Got to put two screws in. I'll move on to the next one. So far it's not a bad day. You know? What's up, man? How you doing? That's my neighbor's like, what the hell is he doing up there? A little maintenance. Everybody's doing some maintenance. It's number two. Can you hear that hum it's making? The same thing, it's spinning so fast. The CMOS sensor. They have a little rolling shutter. It's kind of what it looks like. It almost looks like it's not spinning at all. Very, very fast. I want to reduce that noise. Maintenance. Yeah. Can you see the lack of lubrication there? I can't tell if it's blurry or not because it's so sunny up here. Let me see. Anyway, see how it looks all gummy? Yeah, that's not supposed to be that way. So, I guess if your little whirlybird on top of your roof is making all sorts of crazy noise, it just might need to be greased up again. But see, I have it upside down, and it's very, very silent. So I'm thinking it just needs to be greased up. This one, the shaft was a little loose. So I just snugged it up. I think I just gotta grease this one and put it back. So far so good. Yep, gotta get all three. Gotta get that one in there, the one underneath it, the top one, and should be good to go. We'll see what happens. So far so good. Yes, very nice. There's the ladder. That was the scariest part. Scary because I have a hard time with that kind of stuff. Look at that. Encroaching development. It's all good. Rattle, rattle, rattle. Okay. That one's done. That was the last one. Can you hear it? Nope. And there's the other one. Look at it go. Very nice. Vibrating, nasty, crazy, loud noise. Gone. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. I like peanut butter. Peanut butter.